Many laptops suffer from overheating from an accumulation of internal dirt or poor thermal dissipation due to bad design. This Dell XPS 15 9560 is no exception. Before starting, make sure you've removed any static electricity from your body via touching a large piece of metal or using an anti-static grounding strap. Here I am just finishing the removal of the outer T5 Torx screws. On to removing the two crosshead screws hidden underneath this plate. Now we can lift off the base lid. Disconnect the battery. Now to remove the five crosshead screws holding down the copper heatsink above the CPU and GPU. I also disconnect the two cooling fans from the main board and remove two crosshead screws from each one, holding them in place. The first cooling fan has its exhaust port virtually blocked with a large amount of dust. The other fan is just as bad. Now to lift off the heatsink copper tubing. This laptop already has some thermal pads installed, which I will replace with some new ones. I remove the thermal paste from the CPU and the GPU with the aid of some isopropanol alcohol, some wipes and a small plastic spatula. And the same applies to the opposing side on the copper heatsink. Off camera, I clean the cooling fans with compressed air to remove all the dust from the fans and the exhaust ports. Also, I clean the dust from the cooling fins located at the ends of the heatsink with compressed air. The VRM chips in this laptop control the voltage inputs to the processors, and they produce a lot of heat when the laptop is working hard. They can approach temperatures close to 100 Celsius. To help those chips stay cooler, I will apply some thermal padding. I made some research and read that the 6WMK thermal pads have the optimum transfer rate for reducing the heat buildup. 1.5 millimeters of thermal padding works well with this specific laptop for the VRM chips. I am also putting new thermal pads on the four larger chips on the right hand side. On to applying the thermal paste to the CPU and GPU. After making a lot of research, I chose to use Kryonaut thermal grease as recommended by many gamers. There is a lot of discussion on how much thermal paste should be applied on a GPU or a CPU. Many expert opinions state a CPU or a GPU should only have a small blob placed on each processor and shouldn't be spread with a spatula. The heatsink compression against the processor and the heat will allow the paste to spread to the correct thickness. Placing too much paste on the CPU or GPU will decrease the thermal transfer efficiency. Now to place the heatsink and the cooling fans back in place and reconnect them to the main board and also reconnect the battery. Don't be tempted to lift the heatsink at this point, you only cause air bubbles within the thermal paste, decreasing its efficiency. After completing this procedure, the laptop managed to reduce the video rendering times by nearly 50%. But the newly installed thermal pads and the thermal paste are also helping to keep the laptop temperatures far lower, so in turn the processing speeds remain higher. If you have any comments or questions, please put them below. If the video was useful, please consider giving it a like or subscribing to my channel. Many thanks.